Hey, good morning. Thank God I'm blessed. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. I'm blessed. Bible says I'm blessed, therefore I am blessed. Redeemed out of the yoke, the poverty, the sick, the unrighteousness. We talked 2 days ago now about the great substitution. Jesus paid all that for us. But we are redeemed into the blessing of God. And blessed is he that seeks God and doesn't look after the things of the world. Let me read out of Deuteronomy 28 just some of these blessings that you are redeemed into. It says here, blessed shall be the fruit of thy body. In other words, your children are going to be blessed. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle. So anything that you do, employed-wise or business-wise, has got to be blessed. The increase of thy flocks. Blessed shall thy be in thy basket and in thy store. That means that when you go shopping, you got more than enough money to buy whatever you want, but blessed in your store, that's your storehouse with lots of money. Watch this. Blessed thou shalt thou be when you come in. I love this. And blessed thou shalt thou be when you goest out. Oh, we were so broke one time in our life that we never knew for sure if they would turn the power off at the house before we got a chance to pay it. And we'd go off on a trip for 2 or 3 days and come home and the power be off. That's not a blessing, that's a curse. Well, I'm blessed now when I come in. It's been years since the power's been turned off, and I have the money to pay the bill that hadn't even come in yet. But I got it now. Look, the Lord shall cause, this is God doing this for you, the Lord shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They'll come after you one way, reading right out of verse 7, and flee before you 7 ways. The devil's got to flee. Now, he's been bothering a particular area of my life. And just yesterday, Pat and I realized, hey, this thing's been under attack. Well, I rebuked him yesterday, and he's fleeing 7 ways and going to pay me back 7-fold over the area that he's had. Now, watch verse 8. The Lord shall command, I love that word, command the blessings upon thee in thy storehouses. That's where you store up stuff in your savings accounts. And all that thou settest thine hand unto thee, and he shall bless thee in the land that the Lord shall give thee. You ought to own your own land. Somebody says, well, I'm living in an apartment. That's okay. I don't have a problem with that. But begin to believe God to own your own home and own a piece of land. Put it whatever you want. He shall establish thee a holy nation, and all, look at verse 10, and all people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they'll be afraid of thee because of the blessings that's on you. Blessed into that. Now, verse 11. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods. I'm going to rephrase that. Plenteous in goodies, in goods, in the fruit of thy body, in the fruit of thy cattle, in the fruit of the ground, and the land which the Lord said he would give unto you. And the Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure. It's good, the blessings of God. The heaven to give rain unto the land in the season, and to bless all the work of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations and shalt not borrow. A blessing from God is not having to go borrow for that car that you want. Now, I'm right now believing God for a new pickup truck. I mean, I know where it is. I know what it is. And they made me a good deal on it the other day. And I mean, I liked to did it. Boy, I mean, I wanted that thing so bad. I just thought, they said, well, how do you want to pay for this? And I said, cash. What? I said, cash. And I ain't got that. I mean, you know, it's a lot. And I'm a lot short at the moment. And I almost signed on that dotted line. I said, that's under the curse. I don't have to do that. And God's going to give me one. I don't know from where or how, but I don't have to borrow to get things. It says that I shall lend. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. Above only. Let me read it. Above only, thou shalt not be beneath. If, here's a big word, if you hearken unto the commandments of the Lord your God, which I show you, and you don't go aside from these things. So you're redeemed from having to borrow, but redeemed by having so much, you can loan it. Thought of something last night. I had somebody come up to me. It's been 20 years ago. Pastor, can I borrow some money? I said, well, what do you need it for? And he told me, and I said, well, sure. And so I loaned him what he asked for, and it was a pretty good size sum. And 6 months later, he showed up at church, and I said to him, I said, you know, that money I loaned you back 6 months ago, you said you're going to pay it. He said, well, I did. I said, what? He said, I paid it. He said, you know, I put it in the offering. And I paid it over a period of 3 or 4 weeks. I paid that thing off. I put it in the offering. And I looked at him and I said, well, that didn't do me no good. I'm glad that you gave to the Lord and that'll do you some good. But you borrowed it from me personally. I didn't loan you that money out of the church funds. I loaned it to you out of my billfold. And you put it in the church. Well, great for you. It didn't do me any good. And I got real offended over it, to be honest with you. I got just mad at the guy. You know, I thought, he didn't borrow it from the church. And then the Lord spoke to me. He said, thank God, Frank, you had it. I said, well, yes, sir. He said, you could loan him the money. And even though he didn't pay you back, you're still blessed. You got more than that in your pocket right now. I said, yes, sir. I was down in Cuba a long time ago now, 7, 10 years ago. And we were eating at a very big restaurant. I took the pastor and some of the political people down there out to eat, and they went to the finest restaurant, and a big meal was like $12. I mean, and so I paid for everybody's meal, blessed enough to buy meals for like 8 people down there. And so while we're eating, a security guard comes in, and I see that on the outside, there's one of those big armored trucks. And I said, wow, what are they? And this political guy, the mayor of the city, actually, he said, you know, they take in lots of money here. This is the biggest restaurant in town. And he said, you know, Pastor, he said, they may take up a couple of $1,000, you know, in an evening for their meals. And that's so much money here that it has to be protected. And I'm sitting there thinking, I got to buy my fuel to get out of here. I got to pay my taxes to get out of here. I got my hotel bill to pay. I got to buy dinner for you guys and all this stuff. And I said, you know, I didn't say this to him, but I said, I got more money than that in my pocket, you know, because I had to get by. And I thought, whoo, blessed. You know, they're running around protecting that kind of money. And I got that in my pocket because I'm blessed of God. Get it? Get it? I wasn't living on the economy of the Cubans. I was living on the economy of the United States of America. Well, I'm blessed into not having to live on the economy of the United States of America here. I'm living on the heavens economy. I'm redeemed into God's ability to pay me. And so when that guy borrowed that money and then gave it to the church, that's good. But I was so blessed to have it to give it and then didn't have to worry about getting it back. Blessed. Blessed into the extreme blessings that was on Abraham. Study that in Genesis 16 and 17 and 18 and on through. How blessed he was, and Christ hath redeemed you from the curse and into the blessing of Abraham. Woo, blessed we are. Blessed, blessed, dear God, we're blessed. So remember today all day, hey, Jesus is Lord. Thank God the word works.